read those. The text to this is just a wonderful text. It's interesting how composers throughout history have taken this text and have set it to different music. And I think, in a way, shared their testimony and their faith and their belief in a very powerful way. The first movement of this, the Gloria, opens with the full orchestra and the full choir. The text is Gloria in excelsis Deo. The Et in terra pax is "and on earth peace, goodwill to men." And this is an interesting piece because when you listen to the harmonies and the way that this piece is sung by the quartet, it may not be the type of music that you would put to on earth peace and goodwill to men. I think it kind of sounds a little bit elusive, maybe in the same way that the peace on earth is a little bit elusive to us sometimes. After that, the Laudamus Deo will be sung by the children's choir. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. A very upbeat and happy number. Gratias agimus tibi, we give thanks to thee. Propter magnum gloriam, according to thy great glory. And you'll certainly hear the glory of this very fast and exciting piece. We're pleased to have Sherry Hancock here tonight to sing the Domine Deus, which is a soprano solo. Lord God, Heavenly King, God and Father Almighty. This is the softer side of God, the fatherly side of God. And then after that, we hear the kingly side of God in the Domine Fili Unigenite. We hear the dotted rhythms, dun, 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 which is derived from the French court and from the, that was the, sort of the symbol of the kings at the time, that type of rhythm. That's followed by the Qui tollis peccata mundi, a plea for forgiveness. And finally, we end with the Quoniam tu solo sanctus, which is a return of the beginning movement. And then the grand finale, the Cum Sancto Spiritu, thou alone art God, art most high, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. I was interested to learn that the final movement of this, not to downplay Vivaldi's role in this, but was actually not originally written by Vivaldi. It was written by another composer of the day, who we don't remember, and I don't remember his name right now either, but he took it, and he kind of spiced it up and put it in his movement, and back then, that was considered a compliment. Now it's considered plagiarism, but I think he did some wonderful things with it. So, without further ado, please enjoy Vivaldi's Gloria.